There was a lot on the line as an energetic Ram night performance erupted at center stage. As always, it was anything but routine. The host hunt their first Northern Athletic Conference victory, avoiding any further fallback in the tight race. The guest elevated aspirations of a 2-0 league leap. So all the usual stars will play important roles. Considering these contest consequences wrought with full court pressure. Courtesy of Vaughn Taylor versus Brandon Johnson, this round's round ball ballistics start now. Lately, Allende Taylor has certainly proven himself a bankable asset. While Donovan Martin is reliably flush with cash-ins. Equally enriching the Rams' pivot pockets is Brandon Johnson, a dependable deep depositor against aggressive defenses. While Nightdale can always count on its catalyst, Rodney Ellis, to catapult quick opportunities. Here for Omar Caraballo's Bump and Bop. Then Ellis's dogged determination gained a lead. So Brandon Williams got the lead out, bulleting this bang, bang, bang bullseye. Direction before make connection. Ellis's interference attempted to keep away from Johnson. Only to see Johnson refer to Bishop Radway's threefer. We'll be right back. Kwasim Odom free strokes and a Nick Boone reject. Brought a close quarter conclusion to the neighboring conflict. So proximity intensity was building in each huddle. Especially when the scoreboard room between them was totally erased. And Boone loomed larger than long down low. But feeding Johnson sustained Rollsville. As did Knightdale's ineffectiveness beyond the arc. Of course, Ellis maintained active or radioactive resistance to insistence. Darian Long reclaimed the edge by a lane lean. Then salvage more Williams favor from Boone Danger. While just as Radway's stick back stapled a 6-0 run. Odin ended that spell. And Ellis still pestered the foe plenty more. While Williams plugged into a power struggle which yielded Johnson juice, rather than a fourth Boone block. Williams later sabotaged potential Taylor trouble. Then accomplished the goal of locating Johnson's giant post presence. Though even with only a second to spare, Ellis still shook up the halftime safety spread. Yet while Knightdale's range game continued to plague it, William splish-splashed thrice blows twice in a row. Long gun fun rerun. Just that fast a blast, Williams and Morton were waging a mad dash to the far front of the clash. Cramming and slamming, the door shut. Except Ellis and company would never leave quite so quietly. Odin's drive kept fading hopes alive. And Chris Mitchell slashed the deficit. Ellis's six steal even fueled a furious hurry, proving flip-flop futile. Because Duncan Donovan stayed open for business. Certainly satisfying courtside customers. Knight Travion Cooley applied the heat in the moment. But Roseville got the calling, with Bishop Radway substituting for Brother Justice. Plus Bishop showed hang time at prime time. Even the big man bagged a 19-footer during the 8 of 13, 62% rampaging flammable frame. Thank you. Johnson piled onto his 12-point, 16-rebound nightmare with the Night Mob. Martin managed 12 points and 4 steals. Johnson incredibly accounted for 12 of Roseville's 17 free throw bingos. And Johnson made his final point at a maxed out 26-click margin. While Ellis's 10-point, 6-rebound, 5-assist, 6-snatch batch inspired a late rally. Odin added to his squad's excellent 14 of 15 charity chance cha-chings. Both a bright spot on the stat sheet. Williams would depart with 13 points and 3 assists. Should have been a fourth give. Evan McCormick contributed to the Knights' 36 field goal failures here. But Micah Sumter did shatter an 0-for-17 disaster behind a triple strike soon afterward. So no. Slow-mo shows there was never any Kevlar covering that sniper circle. Ain't that right, Q? The party was going strong prior to the partying. And it spoiled the spirit of Odin's career high 14. Leaving the 9-5 Rams opposite the 10-6 9th enemy legions to exit. But now sitting right beside each other in the standings. Better to already discuss that sequel duel February the 4th. This is Don Fuller, Eastway Television.